Hello and welcome back to Sailing MV. Have any of you ever thought about cutting and reshaping your own sails? In this video, we do exactly that with two of our laminate jibs.
We have to reduce this racing sail.
Yeah, you see how can I cut the panel here?
When you cut them, you'll change the panel shape and so they'll no longer meet at the corners.
I think it's one big cut.
Hey, that material is a Kevlar and a carbon.
We were lucky that MV came with four laminate jibs as well as one smaller Dacron staysail to go on our baby stay. And our laminate jibs were originally designed to go on our Racing Tough Luff, which is a plastic profile which you hoist up the stay and the sails slot into similarly as they do on a furler, only they don't furl. You have to hoist them up and down every time you use it. Since we've now got a furler on this front forestay, all our jibs are too big to fit on it. And they're also too big for the new middle forestay, which we added as part of our refit. We added this new stay because we wanted to have a larger range of sail configurations and make it easier to manage the boat double-handed. Therefore, we needed to reduce two of these jibs, one to go on the front forestay to fit on this furler, and the other to fit on the new middle stay, which we put the Tough Luff on. We cut the Tough Luff and put it on. In a previous video, we talked about the sail we'd chosen for the middle stay. So,
no, I have to use it.
How long is it?
If I have to use it with a Tough Luff.
hang on, no, I'll go and hold it for you.
It's not a big sail. It's not a super big
sail. It's not a big sail.
Daddy
thinks it's not very big. Hello. So next on the list was to pick the one to go on the furler.
Solo!
To do this, we first had to assess the condition that these sails were in. And we also wanted to check their dimensions. So this one is pretty destroyed.
This one, when you compare, this one's in a lot worse shape.
Yeah. Look here, this is all ripped. And here. Where is this one? It says here, 2015, Australia. Yeah, this one looks much better.
I say that material is a Kevlar and a carbon, and the Kevlar, when it start to don't be protected from the UV protection, the material start to be very fragile and come like a cotton. Also in the boat, laminate with the epoxy is very strong. Oh, look like so bad. What's the pulley? This one probably, cuts is not so bad. The laminate is strong. Not bad. Yeah, there is a lot of Kevlar come out. But maybe this material is more strong. I lost so many liters of water. It's not bad.
No, it looks very good.
Yeah, you see, it's a fuck here. But in the end of the day, look like more strong. The other one is only light plastic. This one is full of Kevlar. How many giants this one?
I look like better. Maybe we can cut all the fluffy material. This is not the last.
I take intention the sail and the mizuki on the same time. 22 meter 50.
So in conclusion, the first jib is unusable and the second and third ones are the ones we'll reduce to fit on the two of our forestays. The fourth jib we'll keep as it is for now and maybe cut it down in the future when we have more time. Nemo, you're sweeping the grass. So now we've chosen which sails to use, the next step was to decide how to cut them. Our laminate jibs are what's called triradial, and this is a type of sail that's made up of panels which are triangular in form, and they radiate out from the three corners of the sail, as this is where the loads are distributed from. And as we discussed in our previous video, these sails are more complicated to cut, as when you cut them, you'll change the panel shape, and so they'll no longer meet at the corners.
Right, you suggest me the best solution is do like this, yeah. And reach the first button.
Or you have to go all the way down.
Yeah, but never cut the three sides, only cut the leash.
So if we're going down there, we're gonna mess with the radio?
The problem, what is again? The leash come more
maybe, yeah.
As we explained in previous videos, to reduce the size of these sails, we had to decide if we wanted to cut the length off the top or the bottom. It's more complicated to cut a triradial sail because, as we explained, they're designed to distribute the force out to the three corners. If you cut them, the panels will no longer be triangular and they'll no longer meet in a point. If we cut the base, we'll be cutting two corners, so two sets of triangles. So we decided to cut the top instead. Our jibs were also all designed to be used with battens, which means they all had positive roaches, which means the top part of the sail curved out past the kind of diagonal of the sail. Since we want to use one of them with the furler, we'll no longer be able to use these battens, and so the top part of the sail will flap. So therefore, part of our alterations meant we had to cut the entire leech to change this positive roach to negative, to change the curve from being curving above the diagonal to curving below.
Because I have a really choice, the one I prefer, one Genoa, one jib, is it look like in good condition. We cut the three radial, the only thing is reinforce the leash,
yeah.
And cut all leash in one go, and make it negative, yeah, the only solution, but don't have the, is making a little bit negative, yeah. Garden of our friend to take the measurement for the cut. We have to reduce this racing sail, the G1. We reduce 70 centimeters less. Plus, we have to move all leech from the position where she is and reinforce to here. Like this, we have a 70 centimeters less sail, but also this one sail with the button and the leech is a positive. If you see the perfect diagonal, the leech is more outside, is round, and that's mean when is one sail you oyster on the tough luff is all okay, but when is a frull in one frull, all this stuff with no button go to fluffing and go to be destroyed from the vibration and from the continuity fluff. That's the reason why we cut, and now I have to cut, remove all stitch to the leech and restitch in the correct position, move the reinforce of the head of the sail, the top, and move down. I try to destitch all leech, but the moment I do the first 70 centimeter, I don't know where I have to cut. And now the reinforce got to be very hard, but I have to do. Ciao. Yeah, you see how can I cut the panel here? There's no other way to do it. You can see really how much I got to break the structure. This is what I have to do it. This is the line straight. Now I have to give the negative. Forgive the negative. I have to do one smooth curve. I go to mark the center of this line. Yeah, I wanna go inside 15 centimeter, maybe 20,
And after I have to do one curve, more round possible. And the last 3 meters is outside.
For anyone that would like to see how we calculated this curve, we've explained it in more detail on our Patreon website.
Here in my atelier sailmaker, we have three dogs at the moment. One is mine. Okay, day two. It's still a little bit raining. We try to cut the new leech and so wish more fast possible. First saw wish, not very bad. The machine work very hard on the carbon, and we continue with the reinforcement of the head of the sail. Was a nice reinforcement, all stitch. It's not bad. Okay, this is the new top of the sail and the beginning of the new leech. The best I can. After there I have to continue, but I broke 5 needles, and stupid I don't have more. Before today is done.
Since we'd cut the head of the sail, we reinforced this area by stitching the top triangle, which we'd cut out at the top, onto the top of where the new head of the sail was. So in other words, this part was cut out and moved to here. This helps give the sail back the right structure by helping the forces felt by the sail to continue out to the head of the sail. With the head now reinforced, it was time to cut and restitch the rest of the leech.
After there is the thread, you see, one by one, you don't want to pull out from the material.
We had to be careful to cut the threads properly so as not to delaminate the material.
This is Dyneema.
Here you can see the yellow tape, which is marking the diagonal, and the blue tape, which marks the negative curve, which is where we want to cut along.
Okay, set up to here.
With the cutting done, it was time to restitch this reinforcement back on the leech.
Can you sit in this side? Can you keep like a table? You lift the weight of the material and you try to turn it like this. Exactly. Wow. That is better.
First jib to fit on the furler on the front forestay was now finished. Next it was time to tackle the sail to fit on the tough luff on our new middle stay.
Because our stay is more short, we need to cut the sail in short. The sail 1.70 meters. When we cut out 1.70 meters from 1.3 radial sail, we don't cut the base, the foot of the sail. We have to reduce the sail from the top. And because it's 1.3 radial, I made one reduction in 2 points on the button. One this button and the other button. Change the corner 2 times. And if the button go to support the load of the leech. For the small one we saw is that cut. Only that cut. If we want to do a night job, because we remember it's all positive, we can also record to the next one.
It can
come in more
clearer
to the next one.
Yeah.
And this is the part of leech I remove. Plus a lot of more because there is also from here 1.70 meters.
and the leech is not straight. The other one, we making the leech negative. This one, because we keep the button, because going the tough lap, we use it to keep the leech positive. And positive with the changement of corner in the two button, the last two button. It's quite nice, you say.
This is the one we looked at that time in the loft with Marshall, yeah?
Yes.
The original one. As you might remember from this previous video, Alan pointed out that we already have batten pockets and suggested that we make a diagonal cut from the head of the sail to the first of these pockets.
Why don't you just go like this? Take the tape.
Yeah.
Take it out to the edge of the batten. Why don't you just go like that?
Oh, that's amazing. Done. Easy. Less job.
Yeah.
And we realized the job. We say there, but we better because before Marshall, we consider only to cut from the first button to the top. But like you see here, I cut out 35-40 centimeter sail, and I cut also from this button to that one. Like this is better support. Because the three radial here, like you see, also here is not perfect.
Yeah.
But here, I reinforce with the top of the sail, the last triangle, the last panel is this one, the last panel, three radial, I insert, forgive, reinforce and support.
So you're saying here, this is stuck on top, yeah?
This one, you can see
yeah,
up to
here. Yeah, yeah, it's there on top. But this, here. And it doesn't matter that this line then isn't continuous?
Doesn't matter because going the support to the button. The button is like one structure. It's not okay. Perfect, but
okay.
I can't insert another panel here because after the sail, go to be too much rigid in these parts and go to have one wrong corner, one wrong profile. The pocket of the sail I short and now I have to rebuild like this.
Okay, sounds
and
good.
And this one is one short pocket. I have to repass inside the rope to the leech and restitch. Now in the moment where I continue to reinforce.
Looks good.
Okay. Now, plus we do some job because it's broken also the insert of the tough laugh. Not perfect because it's very difficult for our machine so. In all this sail I made and after I requested to one sail maker to restitch with the correct machine for me make it more strong, but I think it's going to resist. Now I continue the job to reinforce the back of the sail and after I go to put like this and like this. Okay, dai, I continue to work because if I wanna finish today, I have to stop.
Hello.
To
hello. Hello.
Another day again to sewish. The second sail is all ready. The last 2 days I have one problem. I finished the needle because I broke an hole. And I lose it also the timing of the machine and the hook never take the low thread, but after I work with the regulation, I find the correct timing. Today I wanna work with non-stop, reason why I need to prepare all bobbin of a thread ready roll.
want to use a flame? Burn it? Because you damaged too much of the sail.
It's very horrid that this only.
Yeah, but to show how we've done it.
Cazzo, it's too long. Why? Vabbè, go. How much we have there? No, maybe not. No, there is space. Good, wow. So nice, the form. Watch how much is high, the base. This one Yankee. Okay, it's a short enough. And I like the.
I'm good.
I like the form. Space, I short a lot.
We're sailing.
Okay, now we go down. And it's ready to sail, cut, leech, remove this. Because out sail. Because short cut top, made 1 point time, support the leech straight. The leech one, tip the flap, leech, sail, the last I insert, forgive, support, sail, I short, to rebuild, sail, like this, pocket, the leech, restitch, to reinforce, it too much parts, one, the tough laugh, for it, machine, resist, the sail, first reinforce, go to put, like this, it's one, but, cut out, better support.
Just as a comparison, so this would be what it would, what the recordings, those recordings would have sounded like without the Holyland microphone. So I just listened back. Hello and welcome back to Sailing MV. It's amazing, like the clarity. I'm very impressed. Have any of you ever thought about cutting and reshaping your own sails? And they're so small, they're like, you know, they're tiny. Again, for anyone interested in buying these microphones, we'll put a link in the description and a discount code giving you 10% off.